set up with this cipher in this case. Just go like this. Let's open this. What is the... Oh! But if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, maybe you'll get sick of being the monster out of my head under my bed. Hello, welcome to Rifki the Cyber. In this video, I would like to show it to you the threat intelligence reports that already being issued by the SecurityGen company. So we will see what is it. Wait. What is the SecurityGen? The SecurityGen is the company that provide the telecommunication cybersecurity, guys. Their solution is not like other cybersecurity company. Or when they provide the IDS, the intrusion detection system, so many cybersecurity company only provide for the TCP level, TCP/IP level. But this company is not like others mediocre ordinary company. They provide the next generation firewall, they provide the IDS, everything for the to secure your 5G environment, to secure your telecom network solutions, to secure your telecom network security in this case. We talk about the firewall for the GTP, we talk about the firewall for the diameter, we talk about the signaling system number 7, and also we talk about the 5G. So guys, and mainly for the stakeholder of the MNO, mobile network operator, I suggest you, if you want to protect your network, you need to come and visit this company. They also have some professional services in this case. And there are so many genres when they usually do some free webinar as well. So I suggest this to you. You go to their LinkedIn profile. In this case, it's like this. You go to the LinkedIn, find the SecurityGen. Of course, they are somehow provide some webinar, etc. But right now, what I would like to highlight to you from this company is they just recently released the threat intelligence report as my video is recording right now. This is quite insightful, guys. Let's download this one. I'm going to click this and this one, and I just download this one, and then we can see the from the PDF like this. Actually, their finding is quite surprised me, guys. So this is the executive summary. Of course, in the front is SecurityGen, telecom security, transcending generations. This is what I told you guys, the SecurityGen. This is the company. Threat intelligence reports, insecure money transfer mobile network service, table of contents, etc. So when they posting this one, they posting about the threat about the mobile money fraudulence is a valid threat. As in even until right now. And their finding is quite surprising me is, let's check here, technical details. So MNOs were not using encryption on their radio network, radio in GSM network. Wow, this is not really good, guys. And however, switching off encryption also result in the switching off authentications of the radio interface. So we're switching off as many features as possible to decrease network performance drop and offload pretty old telco equipment. Dear MNO or any stakeholding, please don't compromise this. We just want to make efficient of your CapEx, guys. Dropping the features, for example, for the authentications, just only for the winning of the network performance, is not something that bargainable. This is inevitable. This is something that you need to put your CapEx. If you're not afford, then don't release any SIM cards. Okay? Because the data privacy is number one in this case. Let's continue. Scams using different IMSI, TIMSI, etc. Okay, guys, you can feel free to just go to this link, guys, from the SecurityGen. But today, I'm going to jump in the mitigations. We strongly advise turning on the encryptions of the net of the radio network, even weak A51 is better than no encryption at all. As it introduces authentication, make it significant, challenging, blah blah blah. However, highly recommended to use the A53. Well, you know, guys, the A51 compared with the A52, A51 actually is quite stronger than the A52, because in order for you to decrypt the cipher the A52, you just need the software. But for the F51, you really need actually a rainbow table with a lot of hard disk, guys. But I strongly suggest mainly to the MNO to just deploy everything in the F53 if you still have a 2G or GSM in this case. Today, I'm going to show it to you guys, to the audience, how we can harvesting how we can harvesting from the our radio frequency GSM neighbor around us, how to get what is actually our GSM set up with this cipher in this case. If you see from here, this is using the A53 in this example, which is good, guys. But let's see what I'm going to do is, I'm going to teach you how to get this value so you can report it, or you can actually go to your MNOs. Hey, so operators, I want you to upgrade the authentication level or the cipher. The cipher itself to be the F53. No bargainable, guys. Okay, how to do it to harvesting this info? Let's check, guys. Okay, the first thing is we need to scanning the frequency itself. What is the frequency that exists to here? Let's using this GRGSM scanner. I'm going to put the ISO file that already have these tools, guys. Just check in the descriptions. Let's enter this. Okay, this is going to take some time in this case. And of course, don't forget to check this one, guys, after you plug your RTL-SDR in this case. And also, guys, I suggest you to follow, bisa to follow the SecurityGen. You can also follow the most updated as well. Also can from this person, the name is Dmitry Kurbatov, which is actually, he's the co-founder of this company and the CTO of this company itself, guys. Okay, guys, we got already one frequency in this case, 950.4 megahertz in this case. Well, what I'm gonna do, I will just stop this one rather than get all the frequency around here. Basically, I just want to show it to you how to harvesting this kind of information. Okay, guys? Now, what I'm gonna do, I'm going to use this command GRGSM live mode headless. Headless, that means there is no GUI in this case. And then I'm going to use these frequencies, 950.4 megahertz in this case. And I'm going to be ready with this Wireshark. Okay, I'm going to run in the Wireshark now. I'm just using the loopback in this case. And I'm going to use this filter. I'm going to explain to you the filter, guys. Don't worry. Sit back and relax in this case. By the way, guys, don't forget to subscribe and also ring the bell. Put the bell on so you will can get some notifications if I upload new videos, so I can be motivated to provide the new qualities content of this video. Let's continue. Okay, guys, and then I'm going to running this. Oh, yeah. I'm going to filter this first. So I filter this or this or this or GSM type. Basically, all of this is captured in the GSM types. I'm going to running this. Exactly, we get a lot of traffic already, guys. Okay, that means we already capture what is the value around the neighbor around us, guys. So now this is the most important things. I capture all of the GSM tab, right? Because I'm using or and then GSM tab. Now what I'm gonna do, I just want to get only specific for the cipher informations in this case. So there are three ways to do this. So of course I need to eliminate this GSM tab, because GSM tab will give all the traffic of the GSM tab in this case. So I just go like this. So I can using this filter GSM tab data message RR type 0035. From where I get this 35 hexa? It's very easy, guys. We can just get it from this one. Look at this. This is from the documentations from the SecurityGen. If you want to get the ciphering mode, we just need to filter this 035 for the DTAP kind of the type of the message, which is the ciphering mode comment is in the number 35. That's why I put like this, guys. Or you can simply using this one algorithm identifier and filter this. Also, is do the tricks in this case. So from where don't I get this algorithm? It will just from here, algorithm identifier. That's why we can filter from thing in the Wireshark. But actually, you can using this both RR number 35 or identifier. We just filter this one, guys. Okay, guys, sometimes in the predominantly a country that using the 4G or LTE is very rare sometimes using the 2G GSM in this case. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going just to stop this. So okay, I will just stop this and we will get back as soon as possible when we can get this traffic. Okay, I'm going to stop this. Okay, guys, we already got the value in this case. So if you can see from here, we can filter this value, the cipher comment mode, using this GSM DTAP RR message type 35, which is like instructed in this documentations. Or we can using the algorithm identifier, which is we not filter from here, but we filter from this one. If we are using both, that mean or, the logic or, not N. That mean we can using one of them in this case. So I'm just going to this one. Let's open this. What is the cipher mode that... Oh, this is still using A51, unfortunately. Well, if you go back to this documentation, at least even weak A51 is better than no encryption, guys. But the best one is A53. So I already showed to you guys how to harvesting this kind of informations live in your around neighborhood in this case. So if you found this is still using the A51 or A5, even the worst one, the A50 no encryptions, or using the A51, you can suggest to your mobile network operator in this case, or maybe you just can consult with your own local regulatory for the telecommunications in this case, guys. So what do you think? Don't forget to put the like or comments in this case. Don't forget to subscribe. And as I always say in my other previous video, keep learning and stay humble.